defend.
First frame.
Slightly different, I suppose, in this kind of setup, defending a title. He's not straight knockout. He's got a couple of matches today to get going and find his form. Interesting group. I think it's going to be very evenly contested. Looking forward to seeing this young man play as well. I've actually seen him play on a couple of occasions. I haven't played him myself, but he come very close to gaining a tour card this year. Missed out narrowly on a couple of them European events, and he's improving all the time. We're definitely going to see him on a regular basis one day.
Well, on the qualifying school order of merit, he finished sixth, so I think he will get a lot of starts. And it's great to see so many different countries now embracing snooker. The game has never been more international.
Yeah, that's right. Once upon a time, it was just dominated by the home nations and a couple of overseas players. But yeah, I totally agree, Phil. It's great to see all the different nations playing now. More so. Just the last few years, mainland Europe starting to make inroads into producing some top quality players. I think back to people like Luca Brasel doing so well is only going to encourage that and encourage young players to get a cue and take up snooker.
Yes, and the tremendous coverage of so many tournaments throughout the season by Eurosport has had an extraordinary effect on the participation levels and the interest in the game in continental Europe. Mind you, Dave Gilbert will be a handful today if he carries on potting balls like that. What a beauty to start things off.
That was a trademark Dave Gilbert pot, wasn't it? Very smooth. Often talked about, and rightly so, his cue action. Very long, smooth cue action, and when it's in full flow, it is a joy to watch.
Eight.
Very clean potter of the ball. Very strong, prolific break builder. Great cue ball control. That's why he's one of the game's most feared players we have at the moment. Just slipped out the top 16.
Nine.
Just goes to show the level of competition there is out there. Someone like Dave, who was nicely placed in the 16, has just slipped out, but plenty good enough to get back in, that's for sure.
Winning the group here today would do him a big favour, because if he's going to get back into that top 16, he will need plenty of points.
40.
And his first match of the season, right here last weekend, didn't go well. He lost 5-1 to Hong Kong's Marco Fu in the European Masters qualifiers. Fu playing it less than 20 seconds per shot.
17.
Finished off with a break of 115. Had two more 60 plus breaks. Good value for that 5-1 victory.
Yeah, there's plenty of tough first round draws 18. To be had these days, but I think most players will be hoping that when the draws come out, Marco Fu's name is not sitting next to theirs. Obviously a top player, Marco, but had his issues over the last couple of years, so dropped down. This is good stuff from Dave. I think he's got a red to left middle. The way he hit that pack,
22.
He could have expected to land on something a little bit easier, but this one goes in. Plenty good enough. Yeah, just hit the top draw. Just a fraction too much pace. A bit softer, that probably would have taken that, but just goes to show you've got to be pretty accurate in these corner pockets and middle pockets on these Rasson tables.
Yeah, I think the far jaw on the middles is played really brutally. Lots of players have been caught out by that. And missing that red to the middle ended Gilbert's visit. But it cost him nothing. Now that was far jaw again, but that was much more inaccurate.
Yeah, you'd expect Dave to knock them in, but also the red coming back round the table has left the path for this red into the same middle. That's a nice pot. Good chance now for Rorion to get his hand on the table. Fully expect him to be a little bit nervous. So it'd be a nice chance for him here just to string a few together and just settle down a little bit, get used to surroundings.
First picked up a cue when he was 5 years old. He was also a keen footballer and golfer in his childhood. By the time he was 12, he knew snooker was the game for him.
Nine.
Won the Austrian National Championship in 2016 at the age of 14. And 1 year,
17.
He won the Austrian Championship for the loss of one frame.
Well, Phil, I don't know if that tells me that Florian is an absolute world beater in waiting, or there's not too many Austrian snooker players out there. But anyway, that's a miss black off the spot.
And he'll 70.
Very quickly learn that they often prove costly. Yeah, I think that's a sign of nerves. Not just the pot, but the way he went about that. I think later on in the day, I think you'll see Florian probably going into the bunch of four reds there from that position rather than playing up for a loose red. So, understandably, just looking to get a few pots under his belt and settle. Dave has to go into these four reds here. See if he can get a bit luckier this time. Made good contact. How's his luck? Again, first glance doesn't look too good. So hit the pack nicely a couple of times off the brown and not left with anything straightforward. Has to be careful now, though. Now he's got the reds open.
They've got but five.
Aged 15, Nursler got to the semi-finals of the World Amateur Championship, losing to India's Pankaj Advani 7-4. And then the following year, when he was 16, he was runner-up to Jackson Page at the European Under-18 Championship. And that's why Dave Gilbert, wise to treat him with every respect. Also in the summer of 2019, alongside Andreas Plonner, he represented Austria in the World Cup. And Nursel has had lots of experience, but clearly nowhere near as much as the man he's playing.
good pot from Dave there. So it was a little bit of a poor shot from Florian to leave that on. He was looking to get the cue ball tight on the ball cushion, which would have prevented Dave from potting that red and getting nicely on a colour. So
three.
Bit of a gift for Gilbert, but he still had to make sure of the red. Still plenty to do here, though. Balls are not that nicely situated. Four.
Now what a deceptive angle that is. You can see from that shot the black goes easily. Other camera viewpoint looked as though it wouldn't.
11.
Just having a little count 18. Up with the scores there. Since he's 28 ahead.
19.
So two reds, two blacks. We're putting 44 ahead, but not going to be straightforward now with this angle. So having to take this red, it's unlikely he's going to get back down for the black. So
26.
Going to need one of the remaining two reds as long as this one goes in. That was didn't look like a very confident strike, that one. Never looked like he believed that was going to go in. Didn't really know Dave as a great rest player. I didn't think he's got issues with it, but he didn't look confident over that one at all. Stuck this red. Again, not punished. That was a bit of a nervy one from Florian.
Yeah, well, wasn't just missing that red. He caught it so badly. And hit the jaws, literally hit the cushion. The way this works, if you make a lot of mistakes, your opponent feeds off that. They become more and more confident, consequently freer. And when that happens, they're more dangerous.
One.
But that is an improvement from Nursler. Really nice double on the black as well. He could still turn this frame around.
Again, another. It's black.
One.
Really can't afford to miss anything today's snooker, but blacks off the spot are normally very costly. So just this red for Dave to open his account. Safely
one.
In. He's had it pretty comfortable, you'd have to say. Not great from Dave Gilbert, but he's been gifted a few chances here from his opponent.
Another iffy one with the rest.
Dave Gilbert, three.
Gilbert, 38 ahead, 35 on. Nursler needs one snooker.
Well, I think that was, a sign of a bit of inexperience. You're 38 behind with a red left. Ideally, you want to pot the red and black because you're going to need it at one stage. And the way the balls were there, could have potted red, black, yellow. Got a lovely snooker off the green in behind the brown. So, given the benefit of the doubt, it's his first frame. Might be a little bit nervous, not quite seeing things as he probably would do later on in the day. But again, that was probably a wrong choice, shot choice there.
he's left extremely awkward queuing, but the red can easily be popped in.
Dave Gilbert's job for him here. He's just put the black safe, which is to Dave's advantage. So what was a still a winnable frame, you felt, with the balls the way they were, is becoming more and more difficult.
I think you're quite right, Joe. He's clearly nervous. Now, sometimes nerves manifest themselves in a jerky, snatchy cue action. Other times, it's when a player plays too hastily, or in this case, there's no clarity of thought.
One.
Whatever the situation, we can say without fear or favour that Nursler needs to bring about a radical improvement over the next two or three frames.
First frame, Dave Gilbert.
Dave Gilbert committed several mistakes in that frame, but Florian Nursler committed even more. The defending champion is off and running. It is day 15 of the Bedvictor Championship League. I think that maybe Dave Gilbert here has got a logo issue, asking the referee Brendan Moore to help him out. With different issues, Florian Nursler from Austria, who made numerous mistakes in the opening frame and looked really edgy to me. Two groups, of course, today. Group 16 is on table one. Group 19 is over on table two.
For our news later, Beck.
If you're just joining us, I'm afraid Jimmy White has withdrawn from the event. He was in group 19 originally because of traffic jams and congestion, unable to get here in time. So it's a three-man group. Thin contact. The first frame over on table two, which you can see on matchroom.live and the Matchroom Multisport YouTube channel throughout the day. The first frame is still in progress. Ross Muir looks like winning it though, because Jordan Brown with one red left needs a snooker. Just thinking, you know, Joe, before Dave Gilbert won this event last year, he was bracketed together with Jack Lazowski as the two best players, still waiting to win their first world ranking event. And you've been in that kind of situation as well in the past, before you won the Players' Championship in Thailand in 2015. It must be quite a burden.
Yeah, it is. I've said before, I'm not sure if it's a good tag or a bad tag to have attached to you. It's I think if you're classed as the best player not to have won a tournament, then obviously speaks high regard of where you are in the game, but obviously you don't want to have that tag around for long. And it's a nice tag to have as long as you can shake it off at some stage. And yeah, I think the Gilbert Lazowski one was definitely there for all to see. We're just waiting for Jack now to shake his off. You would like to think it's only a matter of time with how talented he is, but I think it's just a sign of the times, how difficult it is to win. You know, the players that are in your way and some of the players you have to beat en route to win titles. It's a tough old tour now, and it's just getting tougher year on year.
It's quite tough for Nursler. Looked as though the cue ball was going to stop on a ball colour for Dave Gilbert, but as we've seen already so many times, this table is like lightning.
Yeah, he needs this one to run, though. This has got to travel.
Foul, the miss.
The line was good. A little bit shorter pace, and I'd be very surprised if Dave puts this back. Gettable red here to right middle.
One.
Pack sort of has a few loose reds, but they're sort of blocking each other. Real clear red, you can see, is the one below the black, which will be a good one to get out of the way early. That frees up the black. Dave being the break builder he is, straight down on that red, but he won't be happy with that shot.
Three.
Looks like it's pretty impossible to avoid making contact with the black here, so got to judge the connection off the black well to make sure he gets out for a colour. It was nicely played, four. But again, he's just going away from the reds here. Can he just get enough bite into this cue ball just to hold for a possible thin red? Don't think he can get any of the pack here when potting this black, so going to need another very precise positional shot here, Dave Gilbert. Can he just get into the edge of the pack, maybe? Just, but there you see, just couldn't generate any pace. The harder you hit that shot, the longer it takes for the spin to come on, and the cue ball wouldn't have gone 11. Near the pack. So again, not quite inch perfect yet for Dave Gilbert.
Dave Gilbert, 11.
As suspected, Ross Muir did win the first frame against Jordan Brown. Brown, of course, whose name appears just above Joe Perry's on the Welsh Open trophy.
Yeah, good lad, Jordan, isn't he? That was a very popular win when he picked up that trophy the year before. I was just chatting to him, actually, before we come on air, and he's using a new cue this season, so this is his first match out with his new cue, so obviously a few teething troubles over there. And on here too, another red when Gilbert's in full flow later on in the season. Normally very, very reliable, that kind of cueing shot. But not quite in gear just yet.
Yeah, the other big change, massive change in Jordan Brown's life, and I'm really pleased to hear about this. He's become a father for the first time.
Again, that wasn't easy. It wasn't a golden chance, but didn't threaten the pocket. Just looking at the way Florian plays, he's got one very long feather, and he stops and then comes back, and he's got a long backswing, pause, so unless you're absolutely timing the ball perfectly, it's going to be prone to wide misses, I think, from time to time with that kind of action. You look at a lot of players on tour now, they're very small, close to the cue ball, short backswings, just with these super fine cloths, just got to try and make everything as simple as possible, and just wonder whether Florian's action might be tinkered with as he starts to play on these tables more and more often.
And that's why
seven.
Mark Selby went from good to great. He shortened the cue action.
Eight.
Now this is a better chance for Dave Gilbert. This is where he and all the top players like to be, in and around the black spot, nicely in close.
14.
To play on the red just to the right of the black if he can, very soon. That will then give him easy access to have a red and the black. Oh, but that's a poor one. Wow, you don't see many of them.
Dave Gilbert.
That
40.
Was a real miss hit from Dave. Very quick, very short, stabby. Something you definitely don't associate with Dave Gilbert. So he's maybe suffering a bit of a hangover from his defeat the other day, Phil, and not 100% confident out there.
One.
Obviously, we're not inside his mind. I would hazard a guess and say that you were actually getting close to the crux of it. He must be feeling aggrieved that he drew Foom in the first round. I mean, that is so unlucky. He's a wild card, Marco Foom, this year in more ways than one. The disparity in the experience and the talent of the players you can draw in round one is massive. And as you said, Joe, Foom is at the top of the list for
eight.
And he plays in the top 64, trying to avoid in round one.
Oh, yeah, definitely. I think as long as Marco avoids like the top eight, top 10 in the first round, he's going to be favourite, I think, whoever he plays. It just goes to show just how good he is. And that was a better shot from Florian, but a little bit unfortunate.
15.
Been expecting to land on something there, something to either left or right middle, but bombs haven't worked out nicely. Oh, just a safety shot, but at least this time he comes away from the table on the back of a positive shot and not a miss.
15.
Real deep Q Sports heritage in Austria, of course, mainly through pool. You think about nine ball pool, Austria have won the World Cup twice, thanks to Mario He and a former world champion, Albin Auschen. Albin's older sister, Jasmine, is one of the leading lady players in the game. And there's a third really good player from Austria as well called Maximilian Lechner. Everybody calls him Max, but I like the sound of Maximilian.
Yeah, I like that too. Sounds like a bit of a superhero. So, escape from Dave. Did leave a possible red, but maybe Florian's decided that be a bit more cautious is the order of the day. Can't keep taking on these risky pots. Green and yellow, nice target here, down the bottom end of the table. Avoids the brown, this is going to be pretty close. Yeah, very good safety shot from Dave Gilbert, good length on the cue ball. Similar problem in Florian here. To try and avoid contact with balls on the way back up to balk. Any mistake here, you feel, could be very costly, or one real telling safety shot. Didn't avoid contact with the balls, but It's about as good as he could have hoped for in that situation. He has left a couple of pots for Dave Gilbert, but could have been easier.
I know he's in front in this frame, but there's been nothing to suggest from Dave Gilbert so far that he's happy with his game.
One.
That was so close. I think a little more pace, even though the cue ball touched the jaw, and that white might still flopped into the pocket.
Oh, he made that look a lot easier than it was. That was probably one of the best pots he's
six
hit so far. Never easy. Awkward cue in. Didn't hold back. I thought he was going to just drop that in, but there was no holding back there. So maybe a sign he's just growing in confidence a little bit. And you expect he would be,
seven,
from what he's seeing from his opponent. Yeah, feels right. He is 1-0 down, but not a lot to be afraid of at the moment from Dave Gilbert. He's offering quite a few chances up.
After losing the first frame, Jordan Brown comprehensively winning the second against Ross Muir on a break of 52.
30.
71 ahead with five reds left. This ready, surely going to enter the pocket. Yeah, we can say for sure it's going to be 1-1.
40.
What a quirky pre-shot routine. We won't see it here because he's using the rest. But we might see it on the pink.
21.
Mannerism, not dissimilar to Michael Judge, who won a group this tournament a couple of weeks ago. Just the way he lifts the cue up and pokes it down the line. It's a very simplistic explanation, but you'll see it here. Yeah, just not quite as exaggerated as Judge.
20. Yeah, I think again he's just missed a little trick there. I think could have just left himself slightly high on this red, and when potting it, could have just cannoned the other red out gently off the cushion.
28.
And there you can see, still going to be able to get that red along the back cushion, but it's going to be tough. Had he just played a little cannon just to release it slightly, would have been a bit of more of a formality. So, Bill, this next shot could determine which way this frame goes.
35.
If it goes in, you'd expect him to get the remaining necessary points needed to win this frame. He misses it. Could be his last shot.
Florida and Newsley. 35.
That shot is so much easier on these Rasson tables if you play it at very quiet pace. When you punch them in like that, so often the ball is repelled.
1.
Really is important when you get chances to clear like this to take them. That was one of the problems for Judd Trump. Yesterday, he had several opportunities to clear and inflict blows on his opponent. And either missed a pot or ran out of position.
Yeah, that's right, but I don't expect Dave to have any such issues here.
Three.
Yeah, just going back to that Florian chance, I just think definitely missed the trick. Yeah, definitely had the opportunity to just bring that red into play off the previous red. Didn't really spot the shot. He just got on the red, then the black, and so much pressure attached to that red that he missed. Pretty much knew it was frame ball, one way or the other.
Four.
And now fully expect Dave Gilbert to take full advantage here. He's going to need all the colours. Played that one nicely, then he just stunned through the gap. Just used the brown. So just a routine colour clearance now for 2-0 lead. One that he didn't
Nine.
Look very convincing about, I've got to say.
Blue to think they're illustrating just how quick the table is. Looked to me as though it might drop short. And it was perfect.
34 frame.
34 clearance for Dave Gilbert to steal the second frame on the final ball. He's not been perfect so far, but the scoreline is he leads 2-0. Florian Nursler from Austria, not had the best of starts, and losing the second frame on the black after being seemingly in control of the frame will hurt. He missed the red, the penultimate red across the top cushion, and Dave Gilbert, the title holder in this Betvictor Championship League, did the rest. As a veteran of countless Championship Leagues over the years, Gilbert knows if he can win 3-0, that would set down a stern early marker.
One.
A nice pop from Dave. Nicely stroked in. So a little bit to do here. See from that overhead angle, the pink's not going to go on its own spot. It's going to go on the blue spot, so that's going to help for the time being. Pretty sure Dave, being the break builder he is, already have spotted the red above the black.
Seven.
He's in the perfect position. When potting it, can just stun down and move the red away from the black to release the black. But again, won't see Dave Gilbert miss many balls as easy as that. So whether he's just confidence is not there, or he's just not quite full concentration, because that's all that sort of shot can be. It can't be anything else other than a lack of concentration. His opponent won't keep letting him off. He keeps getting chances. His confidence will gradually grow. As we've said many times in these Championship League groups, it's so important if you can win your first game 3-0, then no matter what happens for the rest of the day, you've got a chance to win the group later on. And it's a big frame here for Dave.
Thanks. Florian Newsley, one.
Also, if you can, try and put a big break on the board to improve your chances of progress, should it come down to that. And that's exactly what Jordan Brown has done. We saw him on the verge of equalising against Ross Muir. Well, he did so with a break of 115. Gilbert has made the highest break you can. 147, twice in the Championship League. Firstly in 2015 against Zhao Guodong, and in 2019 he repeated against Stephen Maguire. Not duplicating that form though, is he?
Probably news late for.
Dave Gilbert's recently become a snooker club owner, together with Phil Layton and Neil Orton. They've opened Otter's Snooker and Pool Club in Swadlincote. Actually, the club where he started to play as a 10-year-old. They've become the new proprietors. That was earlier this year.
Yeah, it seems to be quite a popular kind of work choice for snooker players. Own a snooker club one day. If anyone knows how to run a snooker club, it should be a snooker player. They've spent enough time in them. But again, it was another poor shot by Dave's standards.
One.
Red should have been nowhere near that corner pocket. if this has landed pretty straight on the brown, there's not a lot of value in taking it on. So I don't think anything pots to the left corner. So it looks like he's just trickling up behind the brown. Got to be careful with these. Again, the way the reds are situated, not likely to get any kind of shot on the back of this, unless Dave completely misjudges it. If that red pots to left middle, that is a misjudgment, and let's give him a little chance for himself here. These are not easy. Very easy to spot the angle when you're so close together, cue ball and object ball, but made it nicely. Nice angle on the pink, so things just looking up a little bit here. Florian is just starting to look a bit more comfortable out there. Two reds at the bottom of the pack going to this right corner. So, yeah, nicely played.
Seven. Eight.
It was clear to me in the middle of the second frame that Nursler looked a little more settled.
16. I wonder if he'll play this one a little bit different. This is the red that cost him.
23.
Leveling the scores at one each. I wonder if he'll just roll this one in this time. He did roll it in, but again, just hit that top jaw, a little bit too much pace, and just when things were starting to look good, missed a tricky red, but one you've really got to be potting at this level. Again, Dave Gilbert not doing nothing to sort of get this chance, has been handed one. I don't think Dave will hang about, leave himself low on this black, straight into the reds, and hopefully build from there.
One. Eight.
Now, is the plant available? Can he get the first red through to the second one? Or is the red just to the left of the first red obstructing? I think he's just about okay. Yes, he is.
Nine.
Oh, that would have hurt Florian there. He'd have been sitting thinking, be getting back to the table very soon, just at the loss of 8 points, but luckily for Dave, that plant was there. So this is a decent chance now. But again, just quite absolutely perfect. So again, going to just have to judge this cannon off the reds correctly. Yeah, he played that 16. Nice, didn't he? So it's all there now. Develop this into a frame win, match winning chance.
Not sure from Dave's reaction. Yeah, 20. You can see there he can get through. Seemed a little perturbed, but there's no reason to be.
24. 31. 32.
On the town of Tamworth, which is home to Drayton Manor. the theme park, and this has been a little bit of a roller coaster ride this match. Not at his best, but looks like finishing with a flourish.
38. 39.
Yeah, I expect Dave to polish this frame off here at this visit, but he's not walking around the table like a man full of confidence. Obviously got very high standards, Dave Gilbert, and rightly so. We've seen him play some incredible snooker.
45.
So he's obviously just drops below them standards, doesn't enjoy it so much, and
46.
Lets us all know this is more like it. Starting to hit the ball a bit cleaner now. He's getting that cue ball exactly where he wants it. It's just a couple of pots away from winning the match 3-0.
Yeah, he's very self-critical. 52. Gilbert always has been.
53.
Not averse to the odd moan. But he's not alone in that.
57. 58.
3-0 it is, with his highest break of the match.
58.
Yeah, Florian Nursler gets up and concedes. And so with a break of 58, it wasn't the best performance from Dave Gilbert.